What up, guys? Disney Chubbs back at it again. And what are we doing today?
A touch of Disney here at DCA.
We're back, baby!
With gloves?
With gloves. Social distance, but we're back. Still got a face mask.
There's your entrance, you get to walk down. So we gotta get our temperature checked right now. Go in here. And we're good to go. So here we go. I'm walking in. Alright, here we are. We're back at Touch of Disney. This is gonna be fun. We're not gonna go and show you guys everything because there's no point to do that because it's already been sold out. Hello, hello.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Oh my god, I'm in the store. I found them. There's only so many left.
Oh, you were looking for those, huh?
Yes.
Okay.
I'm getting them.
Alright, you got them.
I'm getting these ears to do a giveaway. From today?
Oh, you guys heard it. It's a giveaway.
I thought they're cute. They're a classic. You can't go wrong.
Alright, so we're back here at Disney and California Adventures. So much fun. I know it's been a while since you guys seen us, but you know, life happens. But you know, we're here at Touch of Disney. We're not gonna like, you know, show you guys how to do everything because I'm sure there's plenty of videos out there already how to do everything. And it's sold out, so
yeah.
We're just gonna show you the food and eat in front of you. How's that sound? Alright, let's go. And then we'll catch you up as well. We're gonna catch you up to what life has brought us and everything else, you know? And then oh look, she's blonde again. Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm still, you know, regular. But yeah. All right, guys, let's go. All right, guys, so here we are at Touch of Disney.
We're at Touch of Disney, and we are at Smoke Jumpers Grill, which a long time ago, it used to be called Condor Flats. So in my head, I still call it Condor Flats. Okay, so actually what we have today is
yes,
our
I've
favorite,
been waiting.
A Chubb's favorite, and
yes.
That is the Monte Cristo.
The Monte Cristo.
So you can find this, you guys, at Disneyland. And you can find it at Cafe Orleans.
Right.
This is just a half order of it. At Cafe Orleans and also at Blue Bayou, but they are redoing their menu, so I'm not too sure if it will be on Blue Bayou's menu for the reopening, but you can for sure get it at Cafe Orleans. They give you a whole one, and usually me and him will share one.
If you ever followed us or followed us before, guess what? You've already seen us eat several Monte Cristos.
You've seen us like scarf this thing down.
Yes.
But we do share.
Yeah.
We usually get some pommes frites, which those are really good, by the way. And they didn't have them here to complement this, which is kind of sad, but that's okay. But we just get pommes frites and a Monte Cristo, and we share it. And we're full.
Mm-hmm.
So we're going to try this over here, see if it tastes the same. I'm not sure. But bon appetit.
Yes.
He got one and I got one because I said I am not sharing. It's been a while since I sucked my teeth in one of these. And it tastes the same.
Oh, perfect.
It's fresh too.
Oh.
They just like did it.
I'm so happy right now.
Oh, it tastes like Disneyland.
Yep. Oh my god, I'm so happy. So real quick guys, I know it's been a whole year. Almost a year and a half. No, it's about a year since we actually posted anything. You know, life is very busy. We've had a very, very eventful life in 2020. It's been pretty crazy. But things are getting back to normal again, thank God. My prayers go out to anybody, everybody, you guys that are still following us and still, you know, hardcore Disney Chubbers. But really, it's been crazy.
Let's not lie.
It's been rough.
For
I know it's been rough for everybody. So, and we're here at Touch of Disney. It's gonna be a fun day.
And please forgive us. I want to add before we keep on going on. Please forgive us because we haven't been on here. We don't want to come on here half, you know, not feeling it, not giving you guys our greatest. not being 100% with you guys. So that's why we chose to just take that time off and deal with life, deal with things that were going on, emergency stuff like that. Thankfully, our families are okay, and we're doing good, and we're thriving, and we're living. But we wanted to take that time just to take that opportunity just to get through what we had to get through and deal with what we had to deal with and just try to find our new norm
right
with what's going on today. So thank you for being so patient. But we're back.
Yeah, we're back, guys. So you're going to start seeing us posting more often. Actually, you're going to start seeing that we're going to... I'm building a Disney Chubb studio. I'll give you guys a Disney Chubb studio headquarters, you know. So I've been fortunate enough to be able to do a lot more work from home as well. And yeah. So I definitely need to be able to have a studio where I can do more of my my business. And so,
and also because the parks are shut down right now, and they are coming back literally within this month, but we don't know what's going on with passes. They haven't really released a lot of information about that,
right.
And that's okay. But due to that fact alone, we thought, you know what, we should do something to still be us and still bring content. So why not?
Yeah,
go ahead
so
and do things from home.
Building a studio, you guys will see it as soon as we're done. It's going to be fun. We're going to make it all Disneyed up. And you guys are going to see a lot more content from us directly, like as far as, like, you know, just news, updates, things like that. We're going to be, I have like 2 Lego sets that I got to build, Boba Fett and every, and a pilot,
and
you
know,
and
then
just a bunch of lounge flies that she bought over the year. And so we got a lot of updates for you guys. So
quarantine,
you know,
made me loco for lounge.
Oh yeah, oh yeah. I think she doubled her inventory from last time.
I might even say tripled, but we'll see.
Yeah. But all right, guys, let's keep on going. I'm gonna finish this Monte Cristo. She's gonna finish hers. Let's go. Now that we finished eating the Monte Cristos, we're on our way to go get more food. We're gonna go get Golden Dreams, which is chicken wings and some mac and cheese. Sounds delicious. Let's go. The empty river rapids. The no water river rapids.
What is that? That looks disgusting.
I have no idea what this is. All right, we're in second place.
What was it called?
Golden Dreams.
Oh, yeah.
Golden Horizons? Is that? Golden Dreams, we got the wings. At Golden Wings.
Wait,
this is the thing.
I'm not Golden
Wings. Golden Dreams. This is the thing she was calling that disgusting.
It looks nasty.
So it does look... No, it doesn't.
It looks like crab cakes in a jar.
It looks good. And then we also got the...
Carbonara. Mac and cheese.
Carbonara, mac and cheese.
Oh, no. Those aren't cats. Those are ducks.
Oh, my God.
Okay.
You're freaking me out.
Sorry.
Oh, we also got the strawberry rose lemonade.
I think it's
rose.
Which
looks really nice. It's rose because it doesn't have alcohol, so the...
Oh, is that the 2 petals you were talking about?
Yeah. Oh, you know what? I didn't get a straw. But
it's okay. We'll just open it. And
let's just dig in.
Be like...
Here we go.
Sandwiches. I don't know about that. It's all lost.
Come on.
Jonathan says, make it a show. Had cakes in the jar.
All right.
What is the sauce supposed to be on top of it?
I forgot what it's called. But this looks good.
The wings are good. A little bit too much sesame seed.
I like the sauce. It's good.
It's good. Now, would I want these over the ham shanks? No. What they have for the festival here for a festival holidays.
Right. Or the
chicken adobo.
Chicken adobo.
Ugh, they should have brought that back.
And the garlic rice. Oh, so good. I missed that.
Mm-hmm.
Let me try the mac and cheese. There you go. Mac and cheese for yo.
Carbonara. You double dipping?
Mm-hmm. Oh, that's good.
Mm. Ooh, it's hot.
Mm-hmm. You got a nice smoky flavor.
Oh, it's good.
The bacon,
it reminds
nice.
Me a little bit of my Oma's, right?
Mm-hmm.
The Dutch macaroni?
Right.
It reminds me of Oma's.
This one you have to drink it pinky up.
Mm-hmm.
You know, like this. I guess it's a rose petal at the top of it.
That's a big goal. I hear the Incredicoaster.
Ooh. That is really good. I like that.
I don't know yet.
I like it.
I don't know.
More for me.
It tastes like lemonade at first, and then it tastes like perfume.
I like it. It's good. It's almost like...
You know what we forgot? We forgot to do our rating system.
Oh, you know what?
1 out of 5, 1 being horrible, 5 being the best. What do you give the wings?
The wings, I give a solid 4.
Me too. I give the Mac a 4.
4 for the Mac. And, of course, the 5 for the Monte Cristo.
Yeah, earlier.
Yeah.
And for the Rose, I give it a 2.
No, it's a 3 for me. It's good. It's not amazing, but it's good. All right, let's go. All right, guys, so since Reese isn't going to be doing this one with me because she doesn't drink, I got the little mimosas. Let me see if I can get the name of it. It's called the Road Trip. They have a little card. Road Trip Mimosas from Encore, California. One of them is a Pacific Mimosa. The other one's a Mojave Mimosa and a Sierra Mimosa. The Pacific Mimosa has, that's the number one, which is, ooh. Okay, so here's number one. Okay, the Pacific Mimosa's got sparkling wine, coconut, blue curacao, and pineapple juice. All my stuff is flying away. All right, here we go. Cheers. Oh, that's pretty good. It's not bad. I can taste the coconut. Very faint pineapple juice in the back, but it's pretty good. Number two is basically the Mojave Mimosa, sparkling wine, peach juice, and raspberry syrup. Ooh, that one sounds good. Let's try it. Cheers. I like that one. That one's really good. I got a nice little peach flavor out of it in the back. Lastly, the Sierra Mimosa. It's a sparkling wine, lavender, or fresh lemon juice. Ooh, getting bougie with it. Gotta do pinky up with this one. Oh. Not bad. All right, so scale of 1 to 5. The number one, I give like a 2. Number two, I give a solid 3.5, 4. Maybe not so solid, 4, all right? And number three, I think is pretty good too. I give that a 4. Not bad, if you like mimosas, pretty good. Encore, California. I don't know if they're available any other time. And I also got a cheese plate with some grapes and stuff like that. You see that? Pretty good. I got a snack on this one later. So for now, let's keep on going. It's always good to see those two lovable characters back there. Miss seeing them. So much fun to be out here. All right, guys, so right now we're on our way to go chill out at the plaza. We're just pretty much taking it a really easy day, kicking back, taking it all in, eating some good food. But we really miss this spot. It's a lot of fun. Can't wait to go back to Disneyland as soon as they open. By the way, I don't know if you guys know yet, Disneyland is going to be opening April 30th, and they will be... And they will be, you gotta get in front of the camera over here. See, you gotta wave over here. Wave, yeah. So, Disneyland will be opening on April 30th. You can be starting to make your reservations on April 15th and you purchase your tickets. So, we're definitely gonna try to see if we can make it on opening day, but I really doubt it. There's gonna be a lot of people. It's gonna be way too crowded, probably. I know they're gonna be at 25%, so we'll see. All right, so let's go kick it. Alright guys, so this is the next one. We got, what did we get?
I don't know.
From Cluck-a-Doodle Moo.
Cluck-a-Doodle Moo.
We got the sliders and we got the watermelon agua fresca. So
yeah, look how pretty this is. Show them really quick.
Yeah, these are the agua frescas. They look really nice.
But watermelon. Are they gonna taste nice? I don't know. Yeah.
And then these little bad boys.
They have chimichurri.
These little bad boys right here are the...
With pickled
mini
cabbage.
Sliders. Yeah, they look nice.
It's like a sirloin steak with pickled cabbage and chimichurri.
Chimichangas? I don't know.
Something like that. Something sauce.
You see that? There you go.
You bite it.
I'm going to get it.
I'm going to let him test it out because I don't know about the toppings on top. I should have told you to put them on the side for me. But it looks tender.
It's nice and soft. It was a nice and soft bite. It wasn't crazy, like thick or anything. It's not bad. It's not great.
I don't know if it's worth the money if you're to pay for it by itself.
It was $8.50.
You get like a hamburger from a joint.
Yeah. It was $8.50. It's good. I give it a 2. 2. Let me try out the agua fresca.
Yeah, I don't know.
Ooh. That's good.
Is it as good as the Jamaica one they used to have?
It's different. Well, this is watermelon.
Okay, so about
it's
this
pretty good.
Guys, you cannot find this at the parks. So this item, I believe, and the drink as well, you can only find like on a special occasion such as a food and wine festival, festival holidays, anything like that. But it would not be somewhere you could find like at Disneyland. So I think they brought this back because when DCA and Disneyland did close down, it was during wine festival. So I'm thinking that's why they purposely brought this back for this event. So then I'm going to try now. I don't know. It's pretty good. It's refreshing.
It definitely is refreshing. Probably got a wobbly table.
It's good. I give that like 1 being bad, 5 being great. I give that like a 4.
I give it a solid, a 3. You know, I give it a 3.
I give it a 4 because I'm really thirsty and it's really hot today.
Alright guys, so they also have this legacy pass holder little corner where the annual pass holder usually is. And you can get a little button and you take a picture, they link your code. Super cute. And so this is what they give you, a little magnet. And then
a button.
And a button that says legacy pass holder. That's pretty cool. I like that. There you go. And of course they also give you a Disney duck to take with you. I'm just kidding, they're not giving you Disney ducks. Looks like they have games going on and everything. That's pretty cool. It's a long wait though.
Can you imagine Goofy fishing over here? Goofy caught a fish. Oh, chicken.
All right, y'all. Reese is out getting some Band-Aids, so I'm gonna try this out for you guys. I got the carrot cake, funnel cake, fries. Look how yummy this looks. Let me see if I can focus. Focus. Ooh. Very yummy, very yummy. And it's $15 with the little bowl thing. And it opens up. I thought it was really cute. It was a Mickey hat, you know. But why not? I want to go home with at least a souvenir somewhere. Get a nice bite of everything. That's pretty good. I gotta say, it's very good. I don't know where the carrot cake is at. Kind of have like a little bit of carrot cake taste to it. They have like little flakes on it that are carrot cake. But, not bad. I give it a 4. Nah, let's go with a 3. The funnel cake is a little chewy. Oh, what, 3? Well, it's not bad. It's good. All right, well, we can't come to California Adventure and not end up at Cars Land. Of course we're gonna come on the Radiator Springs and hang out at our favorite spot in DCA. Until Marvel Land opens, because I know that's gonna be my favorite spot pretty soon. I think it opens up in June 24th or something like that? I can't remember. I know it opens up in June. I can't wait. So we're gonna chill out. Wait for the lights to come on, because that's my favorite spot, my favorite time. And then go from there. I am super full. All the food has been pretty good lately. I think the only one I was kind of disappointed with was the sliders. But, and oh yeah, and the, what they call them, the funnel cake fries, they were okay. They could have been a little bit crispier, less chewy. It would have been good. So I'm gonna meet up with everybody else. Let's go. Hey guys, so right now everybody's waiting. If you can see around me, everybody's waiting for the lights to come on over here at Cars Land. Yes, and they're about to turn on right now. And the lights are turning on. Okay, we got the street lights already getting on. This is my favorite time right here, right now, when all the lights turn on. Let's see it. Copyright. It's all copyright infringement.
Has anyone else been here when that happened? Have any of them? Like, I wonder if anyone's been here.
I don't know. Have you guys been here?
Man, at night is better than Car Land
at day. Oh yeah, definitely. I would have definitely agree. It's one of my favorite things to happen is when the lights turn on. I imagine in my head, you know, cruising down the street with everybody else, you know? So it's so much fun. I love it. I miss it so much. Brings back a lot of memories.
Like, I could just sit on a bench here forever. Yeah.
All right, guys, so we're wrapping up this event. What's it called? The Touch of Disney or Social
Don't
Distance?
Don't Touch a Disney.
Don't Touch a Disney. And I enjoyed it.
I enjoyed it for being back.
Did you? Yeah. Okay. So if this was an event in any other time, I would say this event was not worth it. Skip it. All right. But that being said, I haven't been to Disneyland or DCA.
We haven't set foot on Disney property
in over a year.
Yeah.
So I definitely wanted to get my Disney fix.
Yeah, me too.
And I was willing to pay whatever it took.
I would say for nostalgic reasons and stuff like that, yes. But for the food festival part of it, no.
The food was okay. It wasn't like great. It was good.
But it wasn't a wine festival, or it wasn't a holiday.
Or the holiday festival.
Yeah,
those are our favorite. But it was
overall
it was good.
I
enjoyed it. Was the money worth it just to come back?
Yeah.
I would have paid more.
Oh shoot.
You know, I don't care. Just to come back here and be in DCA and just get your Disney fix. I got to see Mickey, I got to see Minnie,
yeah.
I got to see Donald,
I got to go shopping.
Goofy, Max. And she got to go shopping.
And we got to be stress-free for a while.
We were with friends and family.
We got to go back to living to fantasy, our Disney
yeah,
fantasy.
It's like, it felt like a home away from home. I definitely would have paid more if I had to pay more.
Yeah, true.
You know, but if this, like I said, if this was any other event without COVID and all, it was just like regular, I would have said skip it. But that being said, I enjoyed it.
You guys, my ice cream's melting. I'm so sorry.
Oh my god.
But
why is your ice cream melting so much?
Because I have hot
All right,
hands.
Well, anyway, let's wrap this up. Guys, thank you so much. We appreciate it. We love you. We're back. Get ready for more episodes.
And a good, I want to say a shout out to Jon and Rosa. They're in front of us.
Yeah.
For coming with us and keeping us company, because you guys need to find Disney friends who become family, because without them, life is not worth living.
Exactly. All right, guys, that's a wrap. Calling it a day for today. Don't forget to like, comment below, tell us what you thought about the video, subscribe, don't forget to hit the subscribe button,
smash that like button,
and don't forget to hit that notification icon,
ring a ding ding,
to get notified when we post new videos. Big Chubbs out. Little Chubbs.